Python can interoperate with code written in C, which uses a C-like calling interface. But it can be tedious to do this with the tools that are built into Python, and chiefly ctypes. If you do a lot of connecting Python to C, you want this work to be as painless as it can be. Now, I've previously talked about Cython as a way to do this, but there's another third-party project that's easier to work with than ctypes or Cython. In many cases, it doesn't even require a C compiler. It's called CFFI, short for the C Foreign Function Interface. Let's take a look at a couple of examples of CFFI in action. Now, to use a library with CFFI, we need to do a few things. First, we need to pip install CFFI, since it's a third-party module, and I've done that here in a virtual environment. And next, we need to define the signatures for the functions that we want to call from the library. And finally, we want to connect to the library and call those functions. Now, my example here will be to connect to the MSVCRT library on Microsoft Windows and invoke its printf function. MSVCRT is basically a collection of standard library runtime functions, like standard lib in Linux. And printf is, as you can imagine, for printing to the console. The first thing we do is create our function header definitions. And this we can do by just copying and pasting the header definitions from a header file or from documentation and using the cdef function to set them up. Now, this is a big part of what makes CFFI so convenient. We can just work with the text of the existing C headers. Next, we establish a connection to the library with the dlopen function. This find library routine, by the way, this is something that we're using just on Microsoft Windows to locate MSVCRT. We don't have to go rummaging it for manually this way, but this is not something you would necessarily need on all platforms. Next, we create an argument to pass to the function with the new command. And again, the type of the argument is supplied as a string, which can be copied straight from C source or from headers. So we have an array of bytes and the text world. This is another way CFFI can be more convenient than ctypes, by the way. The process of creating ctype variables to pass to a library function, it's clunkier and more verbose than ctypes. In the CFFI, it's more streamlined. And finally, we invoke the function by name through the library object. We give it a string to format and the argument we defined to supply the data to insert into the string. And so when we run this code, we get our output. Now, what's really convenient about CFFI's way of handling interfaces is that if you have 20 functions, for instance, or 200, and you want to bridge to them, you don't need anything except their C headers copy and pasted to do it. You would just place them in the cdef and then write idiomatic Python invocations for each function as you needed it. The alternative is to create Python wrapper functions for each of these functions manually, one at a time. Now, one possible issue with the way cdef works is the more function definitions you have, the longer it's going to take to get them set up. So if you have, say, several hundred functions set up through CFFI, that might impact the startup time of your program or library, since they all have to be processed. So to address this, CFFI has a clever mechanism that lets you pre-compile cdef definitions into an importable module. Here's an example of how this works. I have a module named, appropriately enough, example, with our definitions, and we have this conditional block. And when we run this module directly, this will now set up a file named example with a leading underscore and compile into it a fast-loading pre-generated version of our function definitions. We only need to do this once just to generate that file. And now in our main file, we import that generated file from underscore example import FFI and use that to open our DLL and execute our commands against it. Now, any speedups aren't going to be apparent unless you're dealing with lots of function signatures, but it does help at scale. And again, the only time you need to run the regeneration function is if you change your function definitions. The rest of the time, you can leave it as is. Now, I've shown here a pretty minimal example of CFFI in action, but the advantages should be clear. If you have C libraries with many headers and you want to quickly create Python bindings to them, CFFI provides you with a convenient way to do that, although it does come at the cost of being an external dependency. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.